Hi, I'm Oscar van Deventer, and this is Almost a Cube. When I made the Almost a Cube puzzle and Almost a Gigaminx puzzle, I asked my viewers, what other puzzle would you like to see almosted? Don't know whether that's a verb, but by popular demand, we have here Almost a Cube. And when looking at Almost a Cube, well, you recognize that it's sort of a cube. If you want to see here, it looks like a square, but it's an elongated square. And when we look at the other square, it's also elongated. And in one direction, we see the regular threefold symmetry of a cube. So we have a hexagonal cross-section here. And when we turn by 60 degrees, and then by 120 degrees, we are back in shape. So we can split up the squares in different parts. But the much more interesting aspect is the other cuts. Okay, here we are back in shape. That is, usually in this direction, the cube also has a hexagonal cross-section, but now it's an octagonal cross-section. This will be a bit hard to see, but when I turn 45 degrees, we see everything align again. And now we have turned 90 degrees, here we are, and everything aligns again. And going to 135 degrees, things align again, and we are now in the left-handed shape. And we recognize the left-handed shape because we have here four corners in a row in a zigzag pattern, and at the other end we have four corners in a row as well. And from the left-hand shape you can go to the right-hand shape, and then in the other direction again back to the left-hand shape, or you can immediately go back to the cube shape like this. And with some of the like some of my other recent designs, the puzzle has yet again the strange property that the axis change orientation. So now we have the almost the cube straight up, and we do 1, 2, 3 turns like this, and then we are in the left-handed shape and we return like this. And here we have again the almost a cube shape, but all the axes are now in a different direction. So this is a very special property, and no matter how you turn, whatever turns you make, the axes keep changing direction. So this thing doesn't have any fixed orientation of its axes. And I have the feeling that I have discovered something new and special here, but that's of course up to you, the viewer, and especially the specialists, to decide. So my question to you about this puzzle is also a bit about its shaping. Maybe you have noticed that the surfaces are slightly concave, and the result of this concaveness is that the corners have exactly 90 degrees, so it really looks like a cube instead of something flattened. My question to you is, how do you like this concave shaping? Thank you for watching.